and gents, we are back with our Fallout 4 playthrough here.
And serve.
We are going to attempt to kill this guy for whatever legendary piece he's got on him. But he generates a nuclear explosion because he's a legendary protect charm when he dies, so we're going to engage
protect
and kill
and serve.
These two first is like escorts if you will. We can obtain a little bit of space from him. It appears he's not hostile, though, despite what we just did to him. Looks like he's dead. There's the explosion, and we are good to go. So let's continue looting. We do have to be careful. There are protectrons on the other floors. Could get angry at us, but I think that we were able to pretty successfully deal with that right there, that encounter. Although I'm sure that his explosion has scattered empty Nuka-Cola bottles just everywhere. One left. Okay, very nice. Very nice. This whole side's looted. Let's see what legendary. Oh, we have a hostile above us. Probably another Protectron.
Hey.
Let's give some stuff to our adorable dog here. Particularly some of those Nuka-Cola bottles. What legendary? The VATS Enhanced Chinese Officer Sword. Solid if we are doing a... What am I facing? If it's a ghoul, that's fine. If it's something else, that could be a problem.
I shall feel much better after tea.
That nuke definitely woke him up. It appears that the explosion, by the way, did not shatter the empty glass bottles. The nuclear bomb did not shatter the bottles. That's interesting. But I think we may have looted all these anyway, so that's fine. We're done down here. Let's head up to the next, to the third floor. Oh, and there's one more above this one, too, it seems. A sharp Sith leg. Sharp is good. I'm trying to get a full set of sharp gear. So good to see that. A little bit questionable why there's nuclear material here at a Nuka-Cola plant, but this place has always been a little bit shifty, so I think that I speak for everyone to say that we shouldn't be too surprised that the Nuka-Cola facility is up to a little bit of weird stuff here. I mean, they do have their Nuka-Cola quantum, so it's possible it's for that, but I mean, you never really know what they're up to, because basically, Bethesda made every single pre-war company up to something, whether it's big or small, up to something nefarious. Go ahead, come down the stairs, see what happens. Okay, good looting there. Nothing over here, right? Just empty Protectrons. Those must be the three charging stations for the three Protectrons. Hit us with that nice autosave there. Yeah, I think that explosion did toss around some of the junk, even this high up, so that's a little bit annoying. But mostly okay. Let's go ahead and deal with this Pharaoh ghoul here.
I could see that, if not actually disgruntled.
A lot of rounds.
This one was far from being grunt.
Yes, I do agree with you there. Let's trade Dustworth, see what you got.
Certainly, sir.
Take my junk for me. Capped out right at the high-powered mag. That's alright, though. I'm sure Dogmeat also is pretty close to the end of his capacity. What's my legendary? Okay. Kneecapper laser rifle. Fair. Kind of like that melee weapon we got, except for a couple legs. Still not a bad legendary, though. By any means. That one we could use to cripple a Deathclaw, perhaps. We ever come up against one or a behemoth or anything like that, even in a late game, because damage is not what I'm looking at there, the damage potential. It's the capability to actually cripple the leg so a more capable weapon can finish it off. That being said, obviously a more powerful weapon is preferable. The laser rifle, fully upgraded, is a very decent weapon. Alright, we are done with the Nuka-Cola factory. This looks like an open cell here, so we will take the time to explore that. It looks very interesting. But then after that, we'll be heading back into the interiors after we drop off a load of loot at our forward operating base. Maybe there are ghouls up here. I don't really know what to expect. Seems pretty deserted. I mean, this building is half blown out. Yeah, this place is pretty dank. Anything up there? Yeah, I don't think so. I see, though, that it's pretty cool they made a central component of this building a support pillar for this bridge. That's interesting. I suppose this is a place where you could jump down off the bridge and come down these stairs and enter Lexington proper. I think that's the point of this little area. We got apartments there. That is sure to be a large area. Another house down that way. Let's get some water and take care of that. Delicious pond water. Yeah, nothing much of value back here. What's my inventory at? Yeah, we have enough that we can go ahead and I think check out the well, this building here is like a whole lot of nothing, right? Maybe there's an ammo box or something up here. Nope, there's nothing. That's alright. Check out this bus station, which is vanilla. I'm a little bit worried about this place because from here you can kind of get easily engaged from Corvega. I don't want any raiders. They don't bother me. I don't want to go over there either yet. So, you know what? Let's forget it. Let's go back this way. Take this more slowly, more step by step. Get some greater barricades built up there. Yeah, we still got plenty of little places here to explore. MedTech Labs Advanced. Okay, that looks like that'll be an interesting find. I think we looted this place. The Deli Mart. Yeah, so we're almost done here. What do we have here? We have a Dustin.
Hi.
I buy and sell. Just put up everything you got and let's see if we can make a deal.
Just looking.
Look at that. This is, I think, a random cap here. Although I'm not sure, and I'm already making the Commonwealth a safer place because she would have died had she come through Lexington without me. Because this town, she would have been either killed by ghouls or raiders, or both.
Over here.
Come on, dog meat. You're running around all over the place. Good boy. 300 Nuka-Cola bottles. Yeah, that's really what I need you
certainly, old bee.
To have for me. Legendary because of encountering ghouls and whatnot. You know, instead of raiders. These obviously don't carry a lot of legendary weapons. Or a lot of typical weapons. So we end up with a huge amount of legendaries. Which would be a good boy. Alright, let's keep moving and check out this hotel. Right there, we got the blue doors. We're gonna head on in. That lady's not careful. She's gonna get just killed by raiders or something. Expecting this to be a fairly significant dungeon, like on par with any vanilla named location dungeon. Less enemies, maybe, but certainly massive. Your ghouls. Come on down. Come to the party, please. Ooh, we got one right there. All right. The counter I was gonna hide behind had a ghoul in it. All right, that's awesome. Definitely creepy to have that happen to me. That's cool. Okay, this floor is clear. The upper floor. How about that, huh? The fog in here is really weird. Okay. Man, we're gonna have to really go breaching clear like every room. Look for ghouls.
Nice.
What ho? Here we go again.
I'm scared to come out of this apartment, bruh. This place is so big. What, is there one in here? Yeah, at least one.
Yes.
Where are you, dog meat? Where are you? Oh god, they're fucking killing him. Dog meat, where are you? Scared me. Whew. this building looks very tough to deal with. Let's see if I crash. I probably will. I'll be surprised if I don't. Okay, well, that's good. We didn't crash. I'm not mad or anything. Okay, that's one down. All that walking around, man, is really creepy. Anything in the Eatatronic? No? Alright, that's fine. Instead of going out and seeking out the ghouls, let's just loot and let them come to us. Cheers, there's a Protectron in the building, keeping me somewhat safe. I like this floor, it's well lit. Lots of corners I can check. Easily clearable rooms. Nothing crazy. I don't have to hear them ganging up and murdering dog meat. Is that a cryolator? Well, well, it looks like we're about to get our hands on a special weapon here, folks.
Bingo.
For ourselves. More safes. Cryolator. How many cells? One.
Excellent.
How much ammo? One. We have one ammunition for this. Yeah, it's a pretty cool gun. I won't lie. Definitely looks very Fallout technology-y. This.
Got it.
Because we can get XP.
Sweet.
This floor is clear. Let's head on down to here. I don't anticipate problems down here because we have a Protectron keeping an eye on us. But you never know when they're gonna start crawling out from some surface or something. This is a big area. This is a big, big building. I always stand back if you can't tell because there's always a chance that you're gonna have a tripwire grenade go off when you open one of these doors. Camera, for that matter. Well, actually, you can probably guess what's happening in there. I don't really want to talk about this. Quite a big storage space down here for this. Is there two staircases here, or did I just miss this coming down? Oh yeah, no, I think there is just one staircase. Advanced door there. This is a big circle, I guess, around a central, like, pod type area. Say those Protectrons are making me feel very safe. Those utility protect rods. I think we've died 7 times here in our playthrough. That might be the count. Yeah, hopefully there's nothing in the fridge. That would not make any sense at all. I've been a little bit. Well, there are 2 staircases up and down here.
It appears.
Okay, let's get into this master door. Potentially a flood of ghouls are gonna come out, we don't really know. But I'm here for it. Come on, how about that? No? How about that? There we go.
Nice.
I see why this was master locked. We've got all the best supplies in here. It's a lot of soap and stuff.
Hey.
Alright, dog meat, take some of this for me, boy. A lot more of that came from in this building, that's for sure. Nothing else? Alright. Fine, dog meat me that way. Okay, I don't like how I just switched to caution. I don't like that at all. Ooh, there's probably enough here just to fill up my 2 companions alone, just in this room. Normally a rare item to be found in the Institute and the Kappa House, I believe. Vegetable starch, yum. Ton of beer. At least they sort of balance this by putting it behind a master lock. One more advanced door down here. Help me out,
buddy. My body has clearly wandered a good deal, but I have an uneasy suspicion that my mind has not wandered enough.
I like that line quite a bit.
How spiffing.
Can I have you trade?
What ho?
Can I trade? Can I trade with you, or you just want to talk? I would like to trade if that's okay with you.
That's it.
Clear. Military ammo bag. Let's get it for ballistic weave. Or good for ballistic fiber, which is good for ballistic weave. Which is something that we will be most definitely getting for this playthrough. done there. One more door, right here it is. Advanced door.
Got it.
Oh, okay. Cool. Just more storage down in these parts. Wow, we have a ton of weight just from that. I mean, we looted a major building supply center underneath, so I guess I'm not surprised.
Protect and serve.
Yeah, those two, they do a pretty good job with that. It's pretty awesome. Definitely a fan of them. Oh, here we are in the diner, an area we've not been before. Scary, let's leave immediately. I don't want to fight ghouls all over encumbered and then able to use stats properly. In fact, I feel like I hear some of them now. Junk shakes the cake for the amount of loot that we have. Obviously, when you're fighting ghouls, that's what's gonna happen when you fight raiders or gunners or stuff like that, then. You're gonna have
plenty of weapons and equipment taking up your inventory space.
For the weapons, including the random cryolator that we got.
That is nice, but that we just still have
the ammo for. Oh, it's the aid. That's what's dragging me down. Those 15 Nuka-Colas didn't help either. Come on down, dinner is served, ding ding. Really gonna make me go up there, huh? Alright, fine. clear the unlocked doors first and leave the locked for later. Those are all locked, so I feel like I can assume there's ghouls behind all of those doors. But they're locked, so they can't bother us. Let's check here now. I think we have another series. Yeah, locked. A door just opened somewhere. Probably in the interior one of those rooms, I guess. Oop, I guess we're actually thirsty. That's what we need. Not more food. Whoops. It does make me feel a lot safer when they're locked, because then you can kind of go ahead and engage clearing rooms at your leisure. We got one in the hallway. I was taking a little nap. Maybe it was hungover a tad. Don't blame him though.
I expect I shall feel much better after tea.
That was a waste. Should have had better fire. It's a little bit close. I wasted like shells and absolutely did not have to there. Well, these stairs here reach the very top.
Sweet.
He's been kind of weirdly... Oh, there we go. Now I can talk. I was like, he's been weirdly not like non-responsive to my commands lately. So. But the late night, he's doing fine. Almost missed that. Sneaky pool cue. Not gonna get past me. Can't guess the reason for the Christmas tree, but that's just me.
Hey.
Some of my junk, boy. Well, this is definitely a large building, like a large dungeon. It also hasn't been like heavily affected by the nuclear blast, like some of the buildings from downtown. So the parts of the building aren't like shattered or cut off, and so it leads to a very straightforward like setup for the building where you can go between floors easily. You can distinguish what the building was supposed to look like interior-wise, like pre-war. It's easy to navigate. Trash can. Okay, let's get down to the floor here and start clearing it out. Just go down one floor at a time.
Nice.
Who's home? Knock, knock. Oh god, the weights. The weights are gonna be so bad. Out in there. I've seen the buff out. You can't hide from me. I know what you're doing here. And I've seen the weights. So. Steak and chemicals. All kinds of big manly meats and big manly chemicals. Make you strong. Takes his workout notes there. Oh, some buff tats I think we just got. Rare chem for sure. Ooh. Maybe him and his roommate were both like in the same boat there. Just insane, being insane lifters. Some druggies. It's like these two tables, one might belong to each of them. And there's definitely plenty here. Become nice and strong. Oh wow, we're overweight. Why would that possibly be? Really? Okay, that's great. Or I guess four guys lived here. Maybe mom and a dad, or I guess, who were super into weightlifting together, and then two kids who were being raised to be hunks from birth.
Heads up.
Good boy. Okay, we have one, two more on this floor. Yeah, so, as the famous nuclear scientist Robert Oppenheimer said, I have become the sleepy, the goer to bed. So I will be ending this walkthrough here. What am I sick with? Just insomnia, that's right. So I will have to be ending this, but we will be back tomorrow, and tomorrow, and we will get another video out for you guys, and we will have a lot more of the Commonwealth explored. We'll have at least this building cleared. I think by the end of tomorrow, there's a good solid chance that we could be getting to Corvega. But that's all for today, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. This is Sorcerer Gaming, signing off.